Hello friends, in this short lecture we'll discuss about a very universal common condition of the eye, that is called as presbyopia. Friends, remember, presbyopia is not a refractive error, it's not pathological, it's a very physiological thing which occurs to everybody after age of 40. So what is presbyopia? Pres means elderly and opus means eye means broadly, you can say once as we grow older, our vision becomes less. So that is, that was one way to define presbyopia by the Greeks. But what is the scientific definition? The scientific definition is presbyopia is the irreversible loss of accommodative ability of the eye that occurs due to aging. It is a normal physiological state due to the loss of accommodative capacity with the passage of time. As you know all, accommodation is a special feature the eyes are endowed with, by which we can focus on the near objects clearly using the accommodation apparatus that includes the ciliary body, the zonules and the crystalline lens of the eye. So around 1.4 billion people will be affected by 2020, around 1.37 billion people will be affected with presbyopia. The average age of those first reporting symptoms of presbyopia is between 40 to 44 years of age. But friends, the age of presentation can vary depending upon the refractive error of the patient. We'll discuss this later on. Early loss of accommodative ability can be induced by certain systematic diseases, medications and trauma. So basically, what is the pathology? Pathology can be inside the, basically we don't know the exact pathology of how presbyopia occurs, but it is because of aging process, and this aging process may affect the lens or the ciliary body and zonules, which play an important role in accommodation. So there are basically two theories, one is lenticular theory and other is extralenticular theory. So according to the lenticular theory, as we grow older, there is sclerosis of the nuclear lens tissue, and which decreases the distance between the ciliary muscle and lens equator, and the lens capsule with age becomes thicker, less extensible and brittle. It becomes less elastic, friends, that may lead to presbyopia. Also, there may be changes like hyalinization of the ciliary processes and ciliary muscles with age, and there may be loss of elasticity of the zonules, and there may be decreased resistance of vitreous humor against the accommodating lens capsule. These are some of the extra lenticular factors that may be responsible for presbyopia. So in emmetropic eye, the far point is of course the infinity, and the near point varies with the age. It is around at 7 cm by 10 years of age. But usually as we grow older, this near point friend recedes, and at the age of 40, it is around 25 cm. So since we can keep the book at 25 cm, we can read comfortably by the age of 40. But as we age more, then the near point of accommodation decreases beyond the normal working range, maybe above 33, leading to presbyopia. So sometimes presbyopia may present early, means before 40 years, at 35 years also. This could be because of uncorrected hypermetropia, means the person is having hypermetropia for the distance as well as near, but the distance you can see clearly by accommodating, but the accommodation will be not sufficient to correct all the hypermetropia for near objects, so he may present with presbyopia. Then there may be premature sclerosis of the crystalline lens or presenile weakness of the ciliary muscle, and patients with glaucoma, friends, may present with early presbyopia. So what are the symptoms? A person finds it difficult to read. Person says that his distance vision is perfect, but he is not able to read clearly the near objects, the newspaper or the mobile. He has to hold it far to read. So this is the main symptom of presbyopia. And especially after reading for long hours, the patient may feel tiredness in the eye, watering in the eye and headache. So what are the symptoms? There is a difficulty in near vision, initially in the evening and dim light, and later in the good light also. Lighting plays an important role in reading. Astenopic symptoms like headache and fatigue of the ciliary muscle. And there may be intermittent diplopia because of associated disturbance of convergence. As you all know, when we
read, or when we focus at the near objects, our eyes also converge. So there may be disturbance in convergence also, leading to diplopia. And these all symptoms are aggravated by long hours of working, leading to fatigue or illness, fever, and other chronic conditions. And there is a reduced amplitude of accommodation, which if we check it objectively. Objectively also we can check the near vision with the help of either Jagger's chart or Roman test type chart, in which the patient will not be able to read the n/6 or n/8 line clearly at 25 centimeter. There may be headaches, there may be eye strain, there may be redness and watering of the eyes, and there may be neck and back aches because the patient has to exert the neck and back to see the objects clearly. So the distance vision is all right. The intermediate vision is slightly affected initially, but as a person grows older, the intermediate vision, that is the vision between 33 centimeters and 6 meters, that is called as intermediate vision, that is responsible for, say, computer, for reading this desktop, or for in shopkeepers, if a shopkeeper wants to grab something and from the shelf and give it to you, then he uses his intermediate vision, so that may be affected. And the near vision is of course affected. So the best treatment of presbyopia is glasses. But before glasses, we can ask the patient to read in good light. Then second thing is that the patient should take frequent breaks, and in case of tall people who are comfortable reading reading at a far distance, they may not require glasses initially. So if all these measures fail, then we have to give glasses. So of course positive or convex lenses are the treatment of choice. So how to find an optimum correction of presbyopia? So there are two methods. One is trial method and other is age method. Trial method means we try it on the patient, and whatever patient feels most comfortable, we give it to it. It is very simple, and we can always compare with the chart, which denotes how much amount of correction a person is required at a particular age. So that is called as age method. So how do we do that? First, we find the refractive error for distance and correct it first, and then we find presbyopic correction needed in each eye separately and add it to the distance correction. The presbyopic add should have at least 50% of accommodation in reserve, and the reading habits, the near point should be taken into consideration according to the profession of patient and the personal choice. Some people like to read from a distance, while some people hold the books very close to the eyes. So we have to check at the person's working distance. Working distance is very important, and we should not give overcorrection, because overcorrection will induce magnification and will induce diplopia, will induce headache. And additional correction for intermediate distance may be required. In trial method, what we have to do is, again, like normal refraction we do, we just hold the Snellen's chart or Jagger's chart at a distance of, say, 30 centimeter, and we test the near vision. And when the patient can read the N6 line clearly, that is our end point. Age method is based empirically and also on clinical experience, and what we have to do is we have to do reading test at a habitual distance in near vision with convex lens of appropriate power, and we can refine our results of course on every patient. So this is the table which I was talking about. At the age of 40, usually you don't require refractive correction, presbyopic correction. Between 40 to 45, we can give around plus 1. Then 48 plus 1.25, 50 plus 1.5, 55 plus 2. But these figures may vary according to the working distance of the patient. So this is the table which is called as Donda's table, which depicts the amplitude of accommodation and age. So comfortable vision at near uses less than or equal to half of the available amplitude of accommodation. And if the amplitude of accommodation is less than 5, then near work becomes difficult. So we can give various types of glasses, friends. People who are having only presbyopia, who are emmetropic for the distance, we can give them monofocal lenses. And they are very comfortable, and they can be used for static long-term tasks. And the glasses should be taken off to see from the distance. Whereas bifocal lenses, if the patient is having myopia or hypermetropia or astigmatism for distance, then we have to add a distance correction and we have to add presbyopic correction to this distance correction. So these lenses become bifocal. So bifocal lenses have got upper portion and lower portion for reading. But this lower, the refractive power of the lower portion is fixed. So this bifocal lenses have got an disadvantage of fixed working distance. Distance and near is the near working distance is fixed. Whereas this progressive lenses, the power of the lens changes progressively as we go from the top of the lens to the bottom of the lens, so that people are very comfortable in reading for the intermediate distance lens such as computer and for near also. But these lenses have got certain disadvantages, like there are peripheral areas with optical aberration and some people never get adjusted to progressives. Contact lenses can be given for presbyopia, but usually we don't give contact lenses. But if a person is having myopia, then we can try these contact lenses because if the person is already using contact lenses for myopia, then we can use these contact lenses. Surgeries are usually not done in presbyopia. It's a very simple physiological condition and it requires a very simple treatment, that is glasses. So thank you, friends. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask me. Thank you so much.